me like that. It's a relationship.
Yes.
It's for you to forsake everything in this world and put Jesus first in all that you do. So that you will not be destroyed, neither will your children be destroyed. The wisdom of God, when you carry the wisdom of God, the journey that takes people years to walk, you can, your own will be quick. Because you are operating under divine wisdom. You are operating under divine wisdom. When you speak, your word will be different. Because you are not just speaking. You are speaking under the influence of the Holy Spirit.
Yes, under the function.
Why would she be in her house and be thinking about me? And said, I know she will sit there. And I'm firing an arrow from where I am. And when she got in, she saw me in another place. So she must have said, wow. You must not be an ordinary person anymore.
Amen.
He said, whoever wants to touch you will bear their judgment. The Bible says, let no man trouble me, because I bear the mark that belongs to Jesus. And whoever wants to try it, the Lord said, watch me, they will bear their judgment. Beloved, it's not enough to be going to church without power. Many people go to church and they don't have power. So what is your proof if you don't have power? And I told you, always try it from little things. Remember I told you, Lord, as I'm leaving, I don't have umbrella. Let there be no rain until I get to work. You must be... You say you have weapon and you don't know if your weapon is working. You must try it. This child that has left home, I didn't see her. She's supposed to be at home at 9 o'clock. Father, wherever she is, acing her foot now. You must begin to use your authority. The Lord will make things plain to you because you are operating under divine unction. The beloved, you must be different from the people on your job. You must be different in among your sisters, your siblings. You must be different wherever you go. You must always demonstrate the power of God. You know, most of us don't demonstrate it. We don't demonstrate it. Somebody is on your job crying or something. You don't say, come, what is the problem? Let us pray. He said, I will defend anything for my name's sake. It's not because of you. Don't be thinking, oh, I'm a sinner. No, for my name's sake. Because you said in the name of Jesus. You didn't say in the name of yourself. So you must always, from now, begin to use your weapon. You must use it. Something is bothering you and you are sitting down there and saying, this thing bothers me. No! You must send a word. The Bible said, he sent his word and he let their disease. You must send your word. Any confusion, you must send your word. Anything that you see that wants to trouble your soul, you must send the word. You must send the word. Philippians 3:10 said, that I may know him. That I may know him. And the power. Beloved, as a child of God, you still don't have the power. You still don't have the power
At least if somebody see you now and see your mom and your dad, they know that you are from them. Because your eyes will look at them like them. You will walk like them. Your nose will look like them. You should be looking like God. You should be acting like Paul said, all I desire is to know him, so that I don't suffer anymore in this world. I met with somebody in Nigeria and they were telling me about Abadis, like how Abadis now know more than the Christian people. I said, let me tell you, those people that goes to Abadis, they are begging human being. I beg God. And if you beg God, you cannot beg human being. I don't care how high and wicked they are. If you beg God, you can't beg human being. Why did Elijah kill 53 prophet of Baal? Because he begged God. And he begged God in the secret and he came to display and demonstrate the power of God in the open. No matter how hard the witch is in your family, they must come down.
Amen.
They must come down.
Amen.
Because the temperature of your prayer must be hotter for them, so that they can be uncomfortable and begin to submit. We was in the family party in Nigeria, and all my nieces and nephews and everybody from everywhere, we gathered together and they said, you pray. I said, okay. And I begin to pray. And I begin to say, evil eyes, go blind. Vagabond leg, walk to the market and don't return. They never hear that kind of prayers before. My nieces, they're like, ah, auntie, that prayer is hot too. I said, because you guys are butter, you don't know. They said, but we like it. I said, uh-huh. They said, but we like it. We never hear. I said, now you hear it. So go and write it down and begin to pray to. Kill them before they kill you. Kill them before they kill you. Because they don't have no mercy. They don't have no mercy. Every evil hand points to me. I say, let that hand wither. My niece said, ah. I said, it must wither. That hand will not carry any good thing in life anymore. They say, wow. I say, it's Grenada that the army shoot. That's what the machine gun. Don't be shooting little. These people are wicked and they are wickedly wicked.
They have their own weapon.
They are wickedly wicked. You must know the power. The power that, you know how many people, crucify him.
It did not.
But the third day, he rose and come back like Rambo. I'm not dead. I just started with you now. Hallelujah.
Yeah.
Beloved, go to Proverbs 24 for me, with me, please. Are we there? Proverbs 24:3. Please let us all read it together. True wisdom
is an arm of human. Understanding, it is the sun.
True wisdom is a house built. And by understanding, it is established. In other words, you must have wisdom. There is no point telling people I'm a born again and da 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 da, and you don't understand kingdom principles. You know how many people go around and say they are born again, and you there is no miracle in their life. So you want to tell me it's God that is wicked like that? Because they don't understand. They don't understand. Beloved, He said, I will not do anything without letting my prophet know. I won't do anything without letting you know. So in other words, from today, you are not an ordinary Christian again.
Amen.
From today, you don't need no pastor. You don't need nobody to be running around you.
Amen.
Your mouth has authority. Your mouth carries fire.
Amen.
The house you need is in your mouth.
Amen.
The cars you need is in your mouth.
Amen.
The good life you need is in your mouth.
Amen.
The marriage you need for your children is in your mouth. It's in your mouth.
Amen.
It's in your mouth. Did you know they said a closed mouth is a closed destiny?
Yes. Yeah.
It's a closed destiny. You must not. The Bible said, do not give the Lord peace until he establish your Jerusalem.
Amen.
Don't give him peace. Don't give him peace. That is why you are in a ministry like this. Because you must take your destiny that the enemy has stolen. You must take it back. Whatever they have taken from you and church changing you or exchange your birthright, you must take them back.
Yes.
You must take them back.
Yes.
That is why the Bible said the kingdom of God suffered violence, and only violent people can get it back. Party time is over. Don't wait for anybody to come and console you. The Bible said they took over David and they took his children. They took all the men's children and wives. And David cried. At a certain time, he got up and the Bible said he encouraged himself.
Amen.
And he said, Lord, shall I go? Shall I pursue? Shall I overtake? And shall I recover? And the Lord said, go ahead. This is the voice the Lord is speaking to you this afternoon.
Amen.
Go ahead. Overtake. Recover.
Amen.
And take over.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
The strength that you need, the Lord will give it to you.
Amen.
The wisdom that you need, the Lord will give it to you.
Amen.
The people that you need, the Lord will give it to you.
Amen.
Even the vision that you have not seen before, today, this week, the Lord will show you.
Amen.
Deep and secret things that you know nothing about.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Beloved, I need you to stand, please. I want you to pray with this psalm. And please, if you need to write it down. Psalm 5 verses 8. Psalm 5 verses 8. Are we there? You know, everything we do in this congregation, we do with the word. Because my own word cannot work. But the word of God, the Bible said, is a two-edged sword.
Yes.
Psalm 5, verses 8.